Hello, good morning, children. How are you all? Yes, let's start our EVS class today. As you know, children, last time we have started a new chapter, that was chapter 4. So please take out your books and pay attention and listen what I'm teaching to you all. Yes, and last time what I taught you, I hope you all have read it. Last time I taught you about the birthday. You all came to know what is birthday, what is wedding, and we also came to know the names and the celebration of national festivals like Republic Day, Independence Day, and Gandhi's birthday. Yes. So today we are starting with the festivals. They are Dasera. Today we are starting with Dasera. I'm reading, you all please listen. Dasera is celebrated as a victory of good over evil. Good means, evil means which is very bad, where lot of evil means where all thing bad happens. Excuse me. So in that case, Dasera is celebrated on that day to bring all the good things in our lives. On this day, Lord Rama achieved victory over Ravana. Lord Rama, what he fought with Ravana, the demon king of Lanka, and he won on this day. On Dasera, Ramlila is organized for 9 nights. On the 10th day, so on Dasera it's celebrated for 10 days. And on the 10th day, we find the effigy of Ravana, Kumbhakarna and Meghnata are burned. On this day, the effigy means the models which are made of Ravana, Kumbhakarna and Meghananda are burnt. So this is the day it's celebrated. Why? It's to bring the good over the evil. So people celebrate Dasera. And children, everybody enjoy going and watching this Ramlila organizations, okay? All mela means all fair is held, stalls are there, a lot of cracker is burst. So this is the festival of Dasera. Now we are going to go. Did you hear the name of Festival of Lights? Have you all? Yes, most of you all know. Festival of Light is what? Deepavali. Diwali. So let us read it. Diwali comes 20 days after the Dasera. After the Dasera is over, 20 days, Diwali takes place. This festival is celebrated. People clean and decorate their houses and shops with electric bulbs, diyas and candles on this occasion. This is such an occasion. Most of the people you find in Diwali, they clean and decorate their houses. You also do, isn't it? We also celebrate Diwali. And on this day, if and all the businessmen on the shops, all lights are decorated, electric, colorful lights are put. You also put on tuni bulbs, isn't it? In your house, children, you find mommy, daddy decorates your house with colorful lights on Diwali. Yes. Diyas in the evening time, mommy puts on candle, colorful candle and diyas. Yes. They decorate with rangoli. Yeah. In this occasion. And what? People wear new clothes, exchange gifts with their friends. At night they worship. On this day, which goddess worship more? Goddesses Lakshmi and Lord Ganesha. So on the Diwali day, we find Lord Lakshmi and Ganesha is worshipped. Children let off crackers. Don't you put fulgeries and all these things? Yes, crackers. Diwali is also called the festival of lights. So we all of us enjoy Diwali. It's a very interesting and festivals which everybody waits for it every year. Yes. And we what? On this day we find laddus. Special sweet of our Diwali is laddu. Moong ka dal ka laddu and budhiya ka laddu. Yes. And also you find the barfis are also given. Yes, sweet. Okay, now we are coming to the next festival. It is Eid. Eid comes after 30 days of fasting. Means 1 month people do fasting. You know what is fasting? Whole day people don't drink water or eat any food. Before the sun rises, they eat something around about 3:30 or 4. And after the sun is set, then only they eat again, they start eating food. From morning to the sunrise till the sunset, they don't eat anything. And this festival is mainly celebrated by the Muslims. And while they do fasting, they do the prayers. What their prayers are called namaz. The prayer which they conduct is called the namaz. So Eid comes after every 30 days of fasting, remember. And people wear new clothes on the Eid day and they go to the mosque. Where do they go? They go to the mosque for praying, and their prayer is called namaz. The youngster get gifts from the elders. The young ones get gifts from the elders on this festival. People greet each other saying Eid Mubarak. So on this day, people greet everybody by wishing Eid Mubarak. A special sweet dish is made on this day. Is called a siwai. So for each special sweet which is made is called siwai. Okay, children. So we came to know about the Sehra, we came to know about Diwali, we came to know about Eid. Now the next festival is Christmas. Christmas is celebrated on 25th December. Every year, and this time usually it's a winter time, isn't it? People decorate their houses with colorful Christmas trees. They go to church to offer special prayers at midnight. Children wait for Santa Claus, who brings gifts for them. Now Christmas is the day, we know it's celebrated by the Christians. This is the day, remember, when Lord Jesus Christ was born. He was born at night, 12 o'clock. So that day, on that day, the Christians go in the night, 12 o'clock, to the church for Mass, means to pray. And on that day, after the prayer, they come out from the church, they wish everybody Merry Christmas. And on that night, do you know who comes? It's a special person for all children. It is Santa. Santa Claus comes on that day night to give gifts to the children. And all the houses are decorated with stars, balloons and Christmas tree. You find people putting on Christmas Santa caps, isn't it, on that day? I think you all also put. Yes. And the special thing which is special for the Christmas is cake. Cake is the main sweet dish for the Christmas. It's not written in the book, but all of you know, we all enjoy fruit cake during the Christmas. Yes, Christmas means cake. And children are very fond of whom? They are very fond of Santas, because at night when they sleep, morning when they get up, they find in the stockings, Santa comes and gives them gifts. So, this is about the Christmas. So, today, children, I have taught you Dasera, Diwali, Eid and Christmas. So, go through this, read over this nicely, okay? Next day, I'll teach you Guru Parab and Holi, these two festivals, and we'll move on to the exercise. We'll work out all the exercises on the next class. So take care, yes, and stay safe. We'll meet on the next class again. Bye.